But yeah, I mean, obviously Limp Bizkit, I know they haven't been relevant since WrestleMania 17, but still, I mean, you talk about the greatest WrestleMania theme songs of all time. You ask anyone that was around for the Attitude Era, 95 times, 9 times out of 10, they will probably tell you My Way and by Limp Bizkit as the most prolific exactly. WrestleMania theme song of all time, if only for that Stone Cold Rock video package.
And man, I'm telling you that I mean, really, that is still, to me, the single greatest video package that that company has ever produced, ever, and mm-hmm. I don't think it will ever be topped.
I agree.
And you know, I hate to say that because you should always be trying to top yourself, but man, it's so hard when you really nailed it home, and it's just like, you hit the ball out of the park so far that, like, it's in space now, and you're not getting it back. Like,
mm-hmm. pretty much.
You know, I think the reason why they're probably not going to give Limp Bizkit any attention was, I forget when I read this, I think it was a couple of years ago, I remember, number one, Fred Durst flipped off the camera at SummerSlam and whatever year that was, 2012.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Or at least I think it was 2012. Anyways, and I know he gave an interview, I forget which year it was, but like he pretty much said, or like, you know, he pretty much gave that simple explanation that everyone who used to be a wrestling fan gives now, like, oh, I don't watch it anymore because it's all this, like it's all PG and all this other stuff now, blah, blah. So I think because, you know, he says stuff like that and because he's not the most admirable person out there, I think that's probably why they're not going to give them any real attention, and I can't really blame them from a PR standpoint. And to be honest, you know, Fred Durst is Fred Durst. I've never really cared for him. I mean, yeah, like Limp Bizkit has had some, you know, has had some like hits. My Way and Rollin', I will consider classic hits. But, mm-hmm. You know, you only use the word classic with a select group of talented artists. Mm-hmm. So, I think that's why Limp Bizkit, it will not, I mean, like, unless if one day they contact Durst and, you know, he's all cool again, which I don't think will happen anytime soon. But, I'm thinking that that's the reason why they haven't contacted them at all.
Yeah, that would make sense. I mean, you just think back at how many times they use them for various events. And, I mean, it's hard to dispute as well that this is the greatest WrestleMania theme song of all time when you combine it with the fact that, like you said, the video package they put together for Stone Cold and Rock and the show that it was used for. Like, I know that we'll talk about it soon enough with WrestleManias where they've had some great theme songs and the shows themselves are terrible. With this event, you had a great show, arguably the best Mania of all time, and then one of the best theme songs they've ever had. But combine that with the fact of the video package and the show itself, I think there is no denying this might be the single greatest Mania theme song of all time.